we have decided to collect views from the residents of Uasin Gishu so that we can deliver a document that contains the views and aspirations of the people of Uasin Gishu. Remember that during the first time when they were collecting the views, the leadership of Uasin Gishu were not given a chance to present their views. And the views were collected in a hotel where some few people went there and we were not allowed, or we were not invited. But this time, in the process of validating those views, we have invited the people of Uasin Gishu. We have, for example, farmers, we have women, people living with disability, religious leaders, political leaders, traders, all those groups, about 10, 11 of them. And we have given them venues where they will sit down and be able to give their views as per the documents that was released in Bomas. And those views on Monday, each of those sectors that we have formed will now bring their views where we shall now consolidate the views. Then on Thursday, we are going to meet all the leadership from Rift Valley. They will be meeting in Eldoret, where we'll discuss and look at common views and what unites us, and in issues that we do not cut across. We are going, each county will present their document, but we'll also give the view that as Rift Valley, this is what we expect. So that when we go for the rally on Saturday next week in Nakuru, we are going to have, we will already have developed documents per county. Remember, we have 14 counties in the Rift Valley. So we are going to present those documents there. And during that time, we will not all of us will talk. There will be some few leaders from each county and few also across the country who will be given views. So not all those who will go to Nakuru will give views, but there will be selected few that will be giving their views. We don't want a situation where we have been seeing in the past, where you get some people behaving like catechists, moving across the country, giving out, talking all over. Yeah. We want to restrict so that we become orderly, and we give something that is different, but that is good for this country.
Okay. Will Raila Odinga be addressing this meeting? Now that you are saying some few people will be addressing.
Well, I will not give names. I don't have the names now. But what we are trying to say is that there will be few. There will be few leaders. But there will not be everybody who will come there will come and give his view. We believe that those who have given their views in the past can wait for the final outcome. But there will be few national leaders that will be there, and also the county leaders that will present their views. I don't have a list now of who will be there. But I know not everybody will come there will give views.
Okay.
And we will request those who have already given their views in other places to respect Nakuru.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Deputy Governor, this meeting was supposed to happen here in Uasin Gishu also. Why is it that it was taken to Nakuru? Is it that you people are not really supporting this BBI fully?
I want to say that we were not involved in the decision to cancel it. But remember, we have said we were not opposed to the document that came out in Bomas. And as a result, we were not opposed. That's a fact. And our leadership have agreed and said, the document that came out in Bomas, we support it the way it is. However, the decision to cancel the BBI rally in Eldoret, it should be answered by the secretariat, because they seem to know why they decided not to involve not to host the North Rift. Because for sure, it will be very difficult for somebody to move from Kibish in Turkana to Nakuru. That will be traveling almost 1,000 kilometers. So we really believed, and this is what we expected, that BBI Secretariat should have held meetings in every county. Because in the 2010 Constitution, we are told that entities should operate or should structure their operations according to the Constitution, meaning that any operation should be based in those counties. So you'll find that some areas are fewer counties and therefore may have more time to present their views. However, for us in Uasin Gishu, you have said, and Rift Valley, we are going to consolidate our views from the people and we are going to present it through the leadership of the governor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Governor. Since as I have heard from the deputy governor there, he's saying that the meeting that is coming up in Nakuru, it's going to be a very unique meeting. And those who have spoken elsewhere, according to him, he's really requesting and asking them to keep off. And even if they will come, he's saying they will not be given a chance to talk. They want those people, the residents of this Rift Valley, for them to speak for themselves and present their views. And they are saying they are not going to give the document to anybody, but the person, the chair of the committee, the BBI. It's a game of still wait and see whether this will happen. Zinzi is assured that, you know, and you understand that Rift Valley, this is a strong hold for the Deputy President William Ruto. So we are yet to see what will be happening in that particular meeting. They are terming it a unique one. Zinzi.
That's